Welcome back to Talkback. We asked our friends on Twitter and Facebook, how can new lawyers contribute to nation building? Jean Carl says, simple. Follow the law of the nation without getting swayed by emotions, popularity, or bribes. Kat Apollonio says, be ethical lawyers. Never lose idealism. Be the guardians of truth, not the guardians of lies. ANC Steady Boy Loxin joined the discussion on Twitter. He says, study first before opening mouth. If study reveals nothing to say, don't open mouth, drop case. We also asked the men and women on the streets about this topic, and here's what they have to say.
I believe that the greatest contribution of lawyers in nation building is our ability to help the poor access justice.
May kasabihan nga po tayo na that those who have less in life could have more in law. So, kung meron mang isang bagay na pantay-pantay yung mga tao sa karapatan po, at minimake sure po ng lawyers na yung mga tao maibigay sa kanila kung ano yung karapatan nila.
Kung matino yung pagsasagawa ng batas, kung matino yung praxis ng mga abogado sa ating bansa, malaking-malaking papel niya para pabigyang pundasyon at mabigyan ng tiwala ang mamamayan sa kanyang pamahalaan.
Okay, we're still talking to new lawyers. The third placer in the bar exams, Cherry Liz Rafal-Roble from Arellano University. Eighth placer, Irene Maria Qua from the Ateneo de Manila University. Elaine Marie Laceda, ninth placer from FEU DLSU Law. Tenth placer, Rodolfo Aquino from San Beda College, Alabang. And from the University of the Philippines, Romulo Ramirez. May I go to the three ladies here? Did you ever for a while consider joining the public attorney's office or the Department of Justice? Elaine?
Yes, when
you
I
did?
Was... But I was still in my earlier years in law school when I really wanted to go into litigation.
Litigation. So that was not the area, the job that you wanted to take. No one considering public attorney's office or becoming a fiscal or...
The OSG.
Or the office of the Solicitor General, or the Ombudsman, and the NBI.
There was this invitation, an invitation letter from the OSG in our school, and I drafted a letter because I wanted to join them.
Well, you did.
Before, so when it was before I graduated from law school. So I think that was the...
So that option is not...
Yeah, that's not closed in my...
Is that closed? Ah,
that's
okay, that's
closed.
Nice to know. They might be needing a lot of lawyers. You need a lot of lawyers in those areas, diba? Okay, so watching the news these days, I mean, the impeachment trial dominates the television and also all the newspapers, no? Is there any other story that has legal implications, caught your attention? And maybe you would like to, if you had a chance, be a lawyer for it. Is there any story now that is in the newspapers, in the television, being talked about that you would want to be a part of? Romulo.
I can't think of any right now, except maybe the impending impeachment again of another justice.
Yeah, okay.
And
what you would volunteer to be part of a private prosecutor or the defense team or whatever?
The UP was the UP Law School was the one instrumental in pointing this out in terms of the alleged plagiarism.
Mm-hmm.
It would be interesting to see how a plagiarism case as it affects the justice system and even administrative system would work out, no? It would be interesting.
Okay, and you, Ding, any present case?
I have not seen anything except probably the Hazen controversy.
Okay.
But I have not really made up my mind what my position would be. Of course, it's really a terrible thing, and Hazen should be condemned. And there is no place in civilized society where you have to be beaten up and maybe killed just to join
just to be a part of it.
Okay,
And Elaine?
I actually share his position with regard to the hazing. I really don't see the point of beating up neophytes just to be able to be accepted in an organization which espouses brotherhood.
Yeah, and you'd be very much willing if you were invited or you had a chance to be part of a legal team that would...
Probably, even if I really want to go practice taxation, I would do that, probably.
I would have to agree with Attorney Romulo that the impending impeachment of Justice Del Castillo is interesting because you would have to think whether that process is being pushed by our congressmen because they see that the impeachment process of Chief Justice Corona is not going so well for them. So I think there is a play
That's
here.
That's interesting.
There is a play here of dynamics, power dynamics between the executive and the judiciary here, so I'm interested in that, but not necessarily that I would be interested in being a part of the legal team for either sides.
Irene, what stories?
I'm very much interested with the comment of Senator Enrile saying that the UP College of Law, the students need to study first before they can voice out their opinions. Mm-hmm. I think the Constitution even provided that they can, any person can vote if he can read and write. There is no other requirement there, so anyone can voice out their opinion and be part of any survey. So it's just my personal view on that matter.
Yes, and why did that strike you?
Because it's like it's a snob statement saying that only those who have the who are in the upper education level can voice out their opinions. It's very it's not accepted in my part because well, I was inspired by my grandfather who was not a lawyer. He did not even graduate from elementary and he had very much he had opinions. He had I value his views and it was him who told me to study law because no one in the family was a lawyer. So I was the first in our clan. And then it was during the impeachment of...
What province are you from?
From... actually, I have a lot of provinces because my father is a soldier. So I was born in Isabela, Basilan province. Mm-hmm. I was raised in Zamboanga del Sur, in Zamboanga City. Mm. I studied in Agusan, in Buena Vista, Agusan del Norte for my elementary and high school education. And I took up college in Mindanao State University. And then when I reviewed, I went to Manila. And I studied law in Manila, so yes. Mm-hmm. But my parents are still in Pagadian City right now.
In Zamboanga.
In Zamboanga.
Okay, so I was asking you off camera, is what makes a student of law while preparing for a bar exam do good in a bar exam? What did you actually do that made you pass, that you don't normally do when you were in college?
Study.
Really? I mean, study how?
Really hard.
I mean, like really hard. How many hours?
In UP, for instance, we do it. We have a lot of cases. Cases means jurisprudence. Okay. No? Cases decided by the Supreme Court. And a teacher or a professor would normally assign 50, 100 cases.
For a semester?
No.
For
the day.
A day?
Yes. For the day.
And you just read the...
You read the entire...
The entire?
The original. The original.
100?
Yes.
How many pages, sir?
The most is Aveliana, which is a book, which is about 1,000 pages. Normally, it's not that bad. It's probably about 50 to 70 pages normally.
But do you browse?
No.
You have to read.
Yes.
And comprehend.
Yes. Okay. And look for the tidbits where the teacher would normally ask you the question on.
Do you use an old book where you think it's...
there's no such...
It's all online?
We do have online already.
Yeah.
But normally, like myself, I would prefer reading them in the normal way with printed.
So you study like you've never done before.
I was studying my classmates in the UP Law School. If I studied as hard as I studied in UP Law School, I would have graduated summa cum laude in Ateneo.
Like, how many hours would that be closer to the bar exams? Like, 24 hours a day, so you'd sleep about 4 hours?
No, not really.
You don't sleep?
No, I'm sorry. No, you do sleep. The review is really more for confidence build. To my mind, review is really more for confidence building, rather than actual studying the law.
Because you would have, you presume that you would have done your work during the course.
The course, yes, exactly. So to me, it's really more taking your time, trying to remember the things you've learned. If you don't remember them, trying to look it up again and trying to understand what it is
all
about.
Do you review with a classmate or a team, a CAN group?
In my personally, I don't believe in having
a CAN group.
A CAN group. I would rather study on my own. I don't know about the others.
Okay. And ending, how was it? How did you study by yourself also?
For the bar.
I
studied the same as I did at law school, because we were told, and I think they agree with me, that preparation for the bar starts on day one.
Okay. Of the bar or day one
of
your
of law school.
Of college. Okay.
So I've been studying, and you know, my memory is not as good as when I was younger. So it has to be repeated over and over to me so that it will stick into my mind.
So it's so the same. Your memory is not as good as when you were younger. Let's talk about JPE's memory.
Oh, yeah.
And he's 88. Yeah. So how was that? How did you improve your retention and your memory? Did you have to drink any supplements?
No. I don't think it improved. It's just the same. So it's just the constant repetition, I think. So from day one, I prepared.
Okay. Quickly.
There are times when you read cases. In my case, after about 10 or 15 pages, I stop and ask myself, what did I read?
Okay. Let's not discourage it.
No, but I'm here.
So No, I'm just kidding. From our comments, more comments from viewers. From Marcelo Cos Gayon, remind them that with great power comes great responsibility. They can do great good, but can also do great harm, yes. Ray Javier says, memorize the rules by heart to preclude unnecessary advantage by more seasoned lawyers. Avoid being bowled out by temperamental judges. Okay, the final stretch of Talkback in a moment. Stay with us, please.